Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we'll be doing a battery change on the solar fan. So what you'll need for this video, you're gonna need a screwdriver, you might need scissors, pliers, and you are gonna definitely need the replacement batteries. So please stay around to watch the entire video, entire demonstration as to what you're supposed to do when changing your solar battery in your solar fan. Okay, so let's unscrew. Okay, so before we finish the unscrewing process, let me just show you that this fan will need a battery change. So you can see I power it on and I'm not getting any power out of it. I tested it with the charger and there's no power in this fan. That means it needs a battery change currently. But always before you do the battery change, the actual battery change, check to see if there's any loose wires. Then you plug it back into the power outlet to see if it will charge after you fix any loose cards in the pan, in the solar fan, if there is any loose cards in there. But if there's no loose cards in there, you can just safe to assume that it is a battery change that is needed. You can also test the battery to see if the battery have exceeded its life. You can also test the battery to see if they are good, if there are power in it before you do the battery change. So let's get straight into this video. Okay, so we unscrew all of our screws. So let's make sure that we keep them safe. This fan comes with 6 screws, and the section with the battery right here, there's a screw there as well. So we take out this one last. Let us do it right now. It's very easy. So you can move your battery. Okay, so this is the new one that we're gonna replace this with. Brand new battery, you can see. Yeah, so you check to see if there is any broken wires. Not seeing any broken wires right now. It's connected. There's no broken wires. So pay attention to the wires that are connected and how they are connected, because you want to ensure that you put it back the same way when you install the new battery. So you can pull the wires. You don't have to cut it. You can just pull each wire. You start with the looser one. Okay, great. So we're gonna replace that. Okay, so for this particular fan, so you no longer need the black one here from the battery. Let's just finish. But you're gonna need the new one. So for this particular fan, you'll notice that the red, let's call it the red card is connected, is soldered onto the power box right here. If you look closely, you will notice that that is the method that they use to connect the battery to the power button. So if you don't have the machine to get this done, what you can do, you can cut the card. So you cut the card like this, and take out the battery. And then for the new battery, very easy. Thank you. to make sure that it is relaxed in the slot. And you will see the date label out on this side here. Ensure that it is exposed to you, that way you know that you had put in the cards properly into the fan. So we can do the red first, since we cut the card, because it is soldered on right here. So if you don't have the soldering machine to attach the battery itself over here, you clip the card and you join it with, you can use electrical tape or you can use these are bonds, and or you can use this type. Okay, so you strip off a little piece of the cord, right, so you can join it easily. You can do the same thing for this one at this, on the battery side as well. Okay, so we have both wires ready, so you can twist it like this. Don't worry, not gonna shock you. Twist it, then you put it in like this. Inside here there's a spring, so it will connect both of them together. Put it in and you twist so that it is connected together. Okay, so you're gonna do the black. You want to ensure that all of the black cords are connected. So if you purchase this particular fan, it comes with 5 black cords or black wires, whichever one you want to call it. So you want to ensure that the one with the battery, I already stripped this one, is connected. You give it a little twist, then you put it in here, just like this, put it down there. You can turn it on to check to see if the fan is actually working before you finish. Wow, you hear that? Yeah, that's good. So this is a good battery. So you twist it like this. Ensure that all the wires are in. If you're using this type, you just twist it and it will just wrap around the spring that is inside. It's very easy to do. You can see it already. So when you're finished, it's supposed to look something like this. Then you want to close up your fan. Ensure that you don't leave anything in there that doesn't belong to inside of the fan. Check for all your tools and all of the strippings that you would have worked with. Turn it over like this. You can turn it on as well. Power on before you close it up. Yep. Good. And this is where you ensure that it is closed. So you're going to use the screws. I like to put in all of them first before I close. So if you want to know how this fan works, if you don't know how the solar fan works, you can check out our channel to see videos there, demonstration video on how the solar fan works. These are very good fans to cut down your electricity bill. Rechargeable batteries are also available, so you don't have to worry about that. You service the fan just like a normal fan. You set up the fan just like a normal fan. Only difference is that it uses both electricity and solar, so you can choose which one you want to power it using. But we highly recommend that you use the solar panel that comes with this fan to power the fan. rather than using electricity. So you want to reduce your carbon footprint, and you want to save on electricity as well. So you can move about with this fan and as you please. You don't have to remain stationed with this fan. You can take it wherever you go throughout the house. You can use it while it's being charged, or you can charge it up, then you use it. Whichever option you choose. Battery life of this fan. When the fan is fully charged, you can get up to 8 to 10 hours at low speed. The higher the speed is, the more energy that it will use. And this speed that I'm talking about is if the fan is not plugged into electricity or the solar panels. So after it's fully charged, you can get 8 to 10 hours. In terms of the life of the battery, depending on the type of battery that you replace with the fan with, will determine how long the battery can last. 2 years, 3 years or more, depending on usage of the fan as well. So if you use a fan for 12 hours, 8 to 12 hours daily, the fan can last you, the battery rather, because you can have the fan for a lifetime, for a very long time, depending on how you carry it. But the battery can last you maybe up to 3 years, depending on how you use the fan. And it's rechargeable battery, so it will recharge daily. So that is it. Everything is closed. Everything is working. Let's see, the light is working. And it's powered on. So this is good to go. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe to our channel. Please like and share our videos with other persons so that they can benefit from our content and to learn how to do their own battery change with solar fans. Thanks, guys.